As an arable farmer, I'm making between £50 and £100 an acre if I'm doing well, but this is a grassland system producing meat, producing fruit and nuts that are edible, and tied in with the agroforestry project. Yeah. When we looked at this, you know, some time ago when we started planting trees, people were saying we were crazy planting trees on all our our best land, but now look at the funding that's available. I've been involved in LEAF ever since its concept, and passionate, and worked with Ian Piggott setting up Open Farm Sunday, yeah, and driving that forward, which I've been really passionate about. Got interested in trees and the Dimmer Nuffield Scholarship, and Stephen Briggs then sort of inspired me into that.
So what tree species have we got then, David?
These are limes, hawthorns, cob nuts, you've got quince, you've got apricots, you've got sea buckthorn, and then the rows of apples and pears and plums, and we've got loads of walnuts becoming available. We've got a cafe now that's going to be running in the early evenings as well, and we've got a brewery on site. And so hopefully we can start integrating with those two more to be selling people things direct off the farm.
Agroforestry brings a lot of benefits in terms of biodiversity. It's another element of complexity in the landscape. It helps with natural flood management, tactical placement of trees and hedgerows, can act to interrupt water pathways and stop erosion.
With working so long now with the Woodland Trust, they come up with an idea that this hadn't been really created at this sort of scale before. They pitched the idea to me, and you know, I'm not making a great deal out of arable farming. Yeah. Looking at their kind contribution, they paid for all the trees as the trial. They pay for all the materials to guard it and things like that. So all we've had to do is to provide the labour and provide the energy to go forward.
Trees have got a place in climate resilience because they can help protect you from extremes of wet in terms of making the ground more permeable, and also from drought. Obviously they can sustain themselves through deep rooting systems when other crops might not do so.
You just see the little bits of shade, that tree, there'd be a sheep under there. It's more important in the dry times, in the heat. The trees, that's one of the main reasons sheep really suffer in the heat, and just that little bit of shade there, they lie under there and they really benefit from it.
It's all about placing the right tree in the right place, knowing where those runoff pathways are, and then there can be a variety of techniques to intercept the water. Basically, trees are great for holding the soil, for helping permeation into the groundwater, and just generally breaking up those runoff pathways, which might otherwise just lead to a long swathe of water and erosion going down the hill.
Here we are in our agroforestry field, where we've got strips of predominantly apple trees. They're heritage varieties. We planted them at 3 metres apart, and we're just going to have a red clover mix. We're going to have wild bird cover as part of an SFI project, and we've got a rye that we're growing. That we've had Tom Stanton from Reading University come and do a 3-year project, and what he was measuring was the difference between the agroforestry field here against the conventional arable field next door, both 15 acres. And over the 3-year project, he found that the agroforestry field had larger amounts of natural predators in the rows, and they were migrating out and meeting in the middle and actually chasing away the predators. So the report clearly shows that the agroforestry was really adding to the biodiversity. My advice for people setting up a system like this would be talk to your kids, talk to your grandkids. This is a long-term project, so make sure it's something that they want to get involved in, and they're not just going to scrub them all out in years to come. Make sure that if you rent it, that the landlord's involved in it, you know, all those sort of things. Make sure it doesn't affect any of your tax implications on succession planning and things like that. And then make sure you get good advice. The Woodland Trust have been brilliant. You know, I could not have managed without the team there.
CSF is able to help and support farmers down this journey of agroforestry, helping placement of trees, planting trees, managing the trees crucially, and also engaging a lot of other partners who've got great experience in this. We can signpost to all the complimentary advice from other partners to help people through agroforestry and make it successful.